Congressman Anthony Brindisi standing by on the line right now. Your ears had to be ringing on Sunday. You were all over the New York Post saying that the Republicans are coming after you.
Was that Sunday or Monday?
Oh, was it Monday? I guess it was Mondays. I thought it was. Either way, it doesn't matter. So it's funny how you've been very, very cautious when it comes to impeachment or any of that stuff. You've been critical of Democrats, saying that we can't waste our time as a country battling investigation after investigation. We have to do the people's work. Yet they're coming at you for doing the opposite, it seems.
Well, that's what the voters have told me they want me to do. They want me to focus on the work. No one's interested in impeachment. What they want to see is us working to lower drug costs, us working on infrastructure, things like that. When I have a town hall meeting, impeachment rarely comes up.
Yesterday, you were out talking about this opioid crisis that we're in the midst of and funding the southern border to prevent that from coming into the country. Talk about that.
So last year, the Congress passed what's known as the Interdict Act, and basically it is legislation that would strengthen our Customs and Border Patrol. And what I am calling for as we move through this appropriations and budget process over the next few weeks and months to fund the act to the tune of $9 million, which would provide technology, screening devices. Most of the fentanyl that comes in comes through the mail, comes in a package. It's not labeled fentanyl, obviously.
Right, right.
It looks like a regular household good or a shoebox or something like that, but it's coming from China. It comes in from Mexico, and this would give the Customs and Border Patrol the resources they need, the technology they need to scan these packages to make sure this stuff doesn't get into the hands of people in upstate New York.
You know, what's interesting is when you look at, even take a look at our harbors, New York Harbor, for instance, when all of the, I mean, we bring in import materials from all over the world, and they come in these giant cargo bins, and I never knew this, but we don't search them. We don't examine them. They're done on a random basis. So imagine the product that's coming in, and we just don't have the funding to be able to search these bins.
That's why when I have said, and I know this always gets back to a discussion over a border wall, whether we fund a border wall,
right,
don't fund a border wall. What I've said is, look, this is a multi-prong approach. We need a wall. We need physical barriers in the areas that the Border Patrol is telling us that makes sense. We need to beef up our technology. You have many trucks that cross over the southern border from Mexico into the U.S. that don't get scanned. We don't have the manpower to inspect every single truck, so we have these x-ray machines that will scan these trucks before they come in. Only something like 1 in 5 of those trucks get scanned. You have the ports, you know, your shipping ports, and you have the cargo containers that come in. So we have to beef up technology. We need physical barriers. We need more Customs and Border Patrol agents. It really is an issue that has to be addressed now, and this is just one area of it, fentanyl, which is coming in from China. It's coming in from Mexico. We need technology to stop it.
I don't know if you're not in the district as much as you used to be, but although I guess you really are, you're traveling all over the place. But if you saw Oneida County, we were how many did we? It was 20 overdoses
and five deaths
in how many days? It's been
like 10 days or 10 nights or something.
It's terrible. Less. It's a real crisis.
Similar. I was with the county executive yesterday and sheriff. They were part of this news conference. They certainly need more tools at the federal level to stop this stuff getting into Oneida County. The same situation is happening in the southern part of the congressional district down in Broome County. The county executive down there declared an emergency because they also saw a spike in overdoses. I don't know if our area got a bad batch of fentanyl or what happened, but that's certainly an issue that we're dealing with right now across upstate New York, and it's reached crisis levels.
What do you, these situations where people become addicted start with pain management, and then they can't get a hold of the Oxycontin or whatever it is that that they need to get a hold of, so they end up going to the street, and then that leads to, ultimately, this epidemic that we're in the midst of. How do we address the real problem? How do we address the pharmaceuticals and coming up with something that allows these people I can't imagine what it's like when you have neck or back pain to the point where you can't get rid of it. You can't sleep. The pain is so bad. You'll do anything you can to get rid of that pain. How do we solve this problem?
Well, it's hard to solve. And what you've seen is this has happened really in waves. It started with the opioid epidemic, where pain pills were being prescribed and abused. Then it moved to heroin. When there was a crackdown on how many pain pills you could prescribe, the crisis then moved to heroin, which could get easier on the street. Now you have fentanyl, which is making it even more deadly. And it has to start. There's really a number of areas you have to work on. You have to have investments in treatment and prevention. You have to have investments early on in education to warn people of the dangers of these products. You need to have investment in law enforcement to stop this stuff from coming into the country. So there's really no one magic solution to solve the problem. It really takes a lot of different areas. But you also have to invest in treatment and prevention programs to try and help break the cycle of addiction.
Yeah. I want to go back just for a second to the story in the New York Post. They're putting out ads that are online ads that are targeting Democrats in New York, and the especially freshman Democrats. The one they seem to be targeting is this New York City area, Max Rose. He's in a couple of the ads, but they mention you. Obviously, your photo is in there. They're tying you into this whole collusion thing. There is no collusion, so stop with the partisan politics. How do you answer that? Because that hasn't been your thing over the course of your young tenure in Congress.
Well, look, there's going to be a political season. They're going to attack me for all kinds of things. I've been attacked in the past. I find myself being attacked more so from the left and now from the right, which means probably I'm somewhere in the middle, which is probably a good area to be. But the fact is, I've probably been more vocal than any other Democrat saying, let's move forward here. No one wants endless investigations. I'm doing town hall meetings all over the congressional district, and I did one last week in Cazenovia in Madison County, and I think it was an hour and a half into the town hall before someone even brought up the name Mueller. But what they did bring up were drug costs. They brought up the opioid addiction. They brought up climate change. They brought up health insurance. These are the things that people care about when they wake up in this district. They're not obsessed with investigations and how we can get the president.
I want to hit a couple of other quick topics if I could. The cable and high-speed internet. I was just speaking to my parents who are still in a situation. They explained to me that they can get cable. Now, it is available for them. They have to pay $6,000 to have the line run up their road. Honest to God. So, because they wanted to buy one of these smart TVs, and they decided it's ridiculous for us to get a smart TV because we have such slow internet, the smart part of the TV couldn't operate. Are we getting somewhere in New York? Is something going to happen here, you think?
Well, the first bill that I introduced was a cable transparency bill to go after big cable providers like Spectrum, who have been taking advantage of consumers.
Yeah.
The Attorney General in New York State did just settle a lawsuit with them, so some people are seeing rebates in their cable bills. It's nowhere near enough compared to what they have overcharged customers in the past year. There has to be more competition. That's why I'm working on legislation at the federal level that I think will help with competition. That's what we need in this area.
Yeah.
We have seen that in places like where your parents live and other parts around the district, these large cable providers will not go in there because of cost. But many of the smaller broadband providers will go in there to provide high-speed internet. And that's where we should try to incentivize some of those smaller companies who are doing this work right now, not these big, large, behemoth cable companies, which, frankly, will not come into an area because they don't see a profit.
Right.
When you say competition, do you mean letting in their legitimate competitors? I'm trying to think off the top of my head.
Well, like Verizon Fios or...
right.
Verizon's just as big as Spectrum is. Yeah. So they have not shown... Verizon has the capability to come
into
our areas of Oneida County, but they have chosen not to. So I'm talking about looking at some of the smaller providers who are maybe not a household name, but are providing broadband services throughout areas of upstate New York. How do we incentivize those companies to do more instead of and cracking down on some of these bigger providers?
Are they currently prohibited from coming in?
They're not prohibited from coming in, but it is a cost factor from them. So New York State put $500 million on the table a couple of years ago as part of a broadband program. Many of the smaller providers have taken advantage of that, while Verizon and some of the larger ones have not. So I'm talking about more programs like that to help incentivize some of the smaller companies who do have to pay a lot in capital costs and try and expand into these areas.
It's really not about cable anymore. It's about high-speed internet. If you have high-speed internet, you can pretty much get anything now.
Sure.
But you got to have
services. All the streaming services.
Yeah.
That's why we cut the cord a long time ago, and now just utilize the streaming service.
And it's only getting better. It really is only getting better. So, all right, Congressman, we appreciate the time. Thanks so much, Congressman Anthony Brindisi. We'll do it again soon.
Thank you, Bill.